Today we will discuss about organized units. Ultrasonics and X magnetostriction. Okay, so first of all, I'm going to discuss about the ultrasonics. So here, the sound wave whose frequencies are more than 20 kilohertz is called ultrasonics. Sound waves whose frequencies are less than 20 kilohertz is called ultrasonics. Or called ultrasonics. So here, this can be produced by a whistle, okay, and a piezoelectric generator or a magnetostriction oscillator. Okay, so here, once I am telling, ultrasonics is defined as the sound wave whose frequencies are greater than 20 kHz are called ultrasonics. Okay, so here. The ultrasonics can be produced by a whistle, piezoelectric generator or magnetostriction oscillator. Okay, so here the ultrasonics can be detected by Hund's tube. The ultrasonics can be detected by a Hund's tube and sensitive flame or thermal detectors and piezoelectric detectors. Okay, so these have greater frequency, means more than 20 kilohertz. More than 20 kilohertz, shorter wavelength and a large energy content. Okay, so here these destroy microorganisms. So they are widely used in science. Here the ultrasonics is widely used in science and engineering, agriculture, yes, so here the ultrasonics are widely used in science, engineering, agriculture and industry, biological and medical fields. So this is the ultrasonics. Okay, so here the sound wave whose frequencies are greater than 20 kHz is called ultrasonics. Okay, and then we will discuss about the magnetostriction. Magnetostriction. Okay, so here, when a rod of ferromagnetic substance such as nickel is placed in a magnetic field parallel to its length, a small extension or contraction occurs. This phenomenon is known as magnetostriction and can be employed to produce ultrasonic waves. Okay, so here this is the magnetostriction and the production of the ultrasonic waves Then we will discuss about the production of the ultrasonic waves is. So here the magnetostriction oscillator experimental array. So already we will discuss the ultrasonic waves the product produce and the ultrasonic wave of production of visible piezo generator. Magnetostriction oscillator. So, the production of ultrasonic waves, magnetostriction oscillator. Here, a nickel bar XY means this is the nickel bar and here this is the XY nickel bar. Okay, so here a nickel bar XY clamp at its center carries two coils, that is L1 and L2. This is one coil and this is another coil L2. Okay, so here the rod has been previously magnetized by another coil whom power it through which direct current is passed. Okay, so here it is DC supply, direct current is passed. Okay, so the frequency of the oscillator can be adjusted with variable condenser C. Variable condenser C. So, when this frequency is equal to the natural frequency of the bar, the longitudinal vibrations of the bar are produced in the surrounding medium. Okay, so here the nickel rod is free at both ends and hence its natural frequency M is given by its natural frequency M is given by, so here that is n is equals to 1 by 2 n root of by dl y by rho density. So here where l is the length of the rod. L is length of the rod. Y is the Young's modulus. Y is the Young's modulus, and rho is the density. What is the density of the material? Okay. So a nickel rod is 10 centimeters. 10 centimeters. Long gives out ultrasonic waves of frequency is 25 kilohertz. Okay, so here the note, the main note of this arrangement is, so here the note is the magnetosection method is suitable for producing ultrasonic waves of frequencies between 15 and 60 kilohertz. And 60 kilohertz. Okay, so then this is the production. So this is the magnetosection oscillation oscillators. This is the most important method of ultrasonics. Most important method of production of ultrasonics. Then we will discuss about the detection of ultrasonics. Detection of ultrasonics. So here the ultrasonic waves in air can be detected by Cook's tube and Onyx nanometer, that is sensitive flame. The modern method of detection is with the help of a thermal detectors and piezoelectric detectors. Okay, so here the detection of ultrasonic waves is, so here the detection of ultrasonic waves, the following are some of the methods employed to detect ultrasonic waves propagated through a medium. So first one is a sensitive flame method. Sensitive flame method, and the another one is Cook's tube method. Cook's tube method, and the another one is thermal detectors. Thermal detectors. And quartz crystal method. Fourth one is quartz crystal method. Quartz crystal method. So here these are the methods of detecting the ultrasonic waves. So here this is the detection of ultrasonic waves methods. So then we will discuss about, first of all, the sensitive flame method. So here the ultrasonic waves of lower frequency can be detected by means of a sensitive flame and a rotating mirror. So here the image of the flame as seen in the rotating mirror shows length when it is placed at the node due to change in pressure. So here the flame appears like a band when it is at the antinode, thus the positions of the nodes and antinodes in the medium can be located. The mediums of the nodes and antinodes, nodes and antinodes can be located in the medium in sensitive flame method. Okay, so here the average distance between two successive nodes or two successive antinodes, two successive nodes or two successive antinodes, so gives half the wavelength. Okay, so thus the ultrasonic waves can be detected by knowing the velocity of the ultrasonic waves through the medium. The frequency can be estimated. Okay, so here this is about the sensitive flame method, and then we will discuss about the Pulse tube method. So here the Pulse tube method, the ultrasonic waves whose wavelength is not smaller than a few millimeters can be detected with the help of Pulse tube. Okay, during the experiment lycopodium, during the experiment lycopodium, lycopodium powder collects in the form of heaps at the nodes. Heaps at the nodes. So here the average distance between two successive heaps gives half the wavelength. Okay, by knowing the velocity of the ultrasonic waves through the medium, so here the frequency can be estimated. So here this method, this Pulse tube method, this method is suitable in the case of gases. So here the Pulse tube method is suitable, very much suitable in the case of gases. So in this case of a liquid medium or powdered coke or air free or sand may be used in the place of lycopodium powder for detecting the nodes. Okay, so here this is about the Pulse tube method, and then we will discuss about the thermal detectors. So the most common method to detect the ultrasonic waves is by means of a thermal detector. So in this method, a fine platinum wire is used. The wire is moved through the medium due to alternate compression and refraction at the node medium, alternate heating and cooling is produced due to adiabatic changes with the temperature. So here the resistance of the platinum wire changes with time. Okay, so this can be detected with the help of a Calendar-Griffiths-Bridge arrangement. Okay, so no change in temperature takes place at the antinode. Okay, and the resistance of the platinum wire remains constant. Okay, so here This is about the thermal detector, and then we will discuss about the quartz crystal method. So in the quartz crystal method, the piezoelectric quartz crystal may be used to detect the ultrasonic waves. So when one pair of the opposite faces of a quartz crystal are exposed to ultrasonic waves, the other pair of the opposite faces develop opposite charges. So these charges are amplified and detected by means of an electronic circuit. So this principle is applied in ultrasonic interferometer. Ultrasonic interferometer. Okay, so here these are the detection methods of ultrasonic waves. Okay, so these are the main detection methods of ultrasonic waves. And then we will discuss about the applications of ultrasonics. The applications of the ultrasonic waves. So, the first application of the ultrasonic wave is, so here the ultrasonics have been used to investigate the structure of matter. Ultrasonics have been used to investigate the structure of matter. This is the main application. And the another one is, so the ultrasonics have been used to determine the velocity of sound in ray gases and liquids away in small quantities. So the determination reveals many physical and chemical properties of substances. Many physical and chemical properties of substances. Okay, so here this is the main second application. And the another application of ultrasonic waves is, so here this can be used to detect the flaws in the metal castings. This can be used to detect the flaws in the metal castings. And the fourth application here and there, another application is, these have been used for signaling in any particular directions. Another application, and then we will discuss about the another application of ultrasonics is, so these have been used to determine the depth of the sea or lake, etc. Depth of sea, lake, etc. And to detect the submerged rocks or submarines and icebergs. So parents, this one subject to gods, and etc. Okay, so this is the another application. And then when this is about the another application of ultrasonic waves is, so here these are used in obtaining colors of uniform compositions. Alloys of uniform compositions, and the another one is this can be used for cleaning cloths and objects like pots of watches, etc. Cleaning cloths, watches, and etc. And the another one is, so here these are used to form stable emulsions of immiscible liquids. So here the principle finds an application in the preparation of photographic emulsions. Photographic. And another application of ultrasonic is, so here the gloss rod. A glass rod oscillating with ultrasonic frequency can bore a hole in a steel plate. Hence, ultrasonics can be used for drilling purposes. Drilling purposes. And the another application is these have been used to lame smaller animals like rats, fish, and frogs, and kill bacteria. Okay, so they destroy red corpuscles, yeast cells lose their power of reproduction when exposed to ultrasonics. Okay, so here this is the one of the main application of ultrasonics. And then we will discuss about the another application. So here these are used for sterilization of milk and water. They are used for sterilization of milk and water. And the another application of ultrasonic waves is, so potato plants when treated with ultrasonics gives increased yields. And the another most important application of the ultrasonic waves is, so these are used to cure neuralgic pains and rheumatic pains. They are used to cure neuralgic and rheumatic pains. So here the ultrasonics have been used to localize tumors in brains. tumors in brains. Okay, so here these are the main and very important, very most important applications of ultrasonics. Okay, so here this is about the ultrasonics, in ultrasonic detection and ultrasonics production and applications of ultrasonics. Okay, have you understood? Thank you.